Do you ever have problems with your gunpla? Don't know how to panel line, can't put stickers on properly, missing parts? Well, today, I can show you exactly how to fix all these problems. Does your gunpla not want to stand up, or it lacks in heels? Well, I can show you how to fix that. On Amazon, I found these display stands, and they work perfectly. They support Gundams, and they're only $16 Canadian, which is probably less American. Also, it's fulfilled by Amazon. To show you that I have one of these, this is the same stand with my Strike Gundam, and it works perfectly. When putting stickers on your Gundams, you don't just use your hands, do you? What I usually do is bend the piece of paper a little bit till the sticker kind of comes off. Then I use tweezers to grab the sticker and very carefully place it onto his shoulder. This is the result of using your tweezers, and this is the result of using your fingers. It just kind of comes off and doesn't even stick anymore. If you can't panel line and can't afford gunpla markers, I'm gonna show you how to do it with household pens. First, you're gonna need a little, packaging knife or whatever it's called, I can't remember. But you're just gonna flip them over and outline the place you want to panel line. This will keep the marker in place. Then you're gonna panel line it with whatever marker you have, Sharpie and whatever. And that's how it looks panel lined. I messed up on this Gundam, but this gunpla, the Witch for Mercury, Aerial Gunpla, I just panel lined and it looks absolutely amazing. This is the result of a successful panel lining, and I think it looks awesome, especially with Sharpie, it pops more.
I just redid my desk. Anyways, let's go back to the video. So, let's say you just built a gunpla, and... Oh no, I built it, and it's missing a piece! There's basically three ways you can do this. You can go looking in the stacks upon stacks of Gundam plates of parts, if you even keep those. I usually do just in case. Or, you know, just buy a new one. Like, that's kind of the only thing you can do. Also, his eyes are... Do they look scratched? I put them on with a toothpick, which is not a great, oh crap, not a great idea. Do his eyes look scratched on camera? No, not really, whatever. Put this thing back. When you build gunpla, you usually have to learn how to manage space. Because you know, you're gonna need it for all the boxes and stuff and everything. So what I did is, my books actually used to be over here, in these little cabinet things, and I just moved them over here to manage more space. And if we go over there, now I have more room for gunpla, so I'm putting all my SD Gundams here. Right now I only have the unicorn one, but right here is my other gunpla. It was really, really dusty, by the way. Sorry about that. But this is where my gunpla goes. I have four right now. Two of them kind of broke. But now I have all this empty space for probably master grades and perfect grades and stuff like that. I'm only just starting gunpla, so I only have a bunch of high grades. But that's one of the biggest problems. And then this is above my gunpla collection of my random transformers. And then my gunpla's right down here. So we got the unicorn one, this guy, the RX-78-2, and the striker Gundam, which this is actually the entry grade.